Hello everyone, X-Force here, and welcome to All Stands in JoJo's Bizarre Adventure Part 3, Stardust Crusaders. We will be looking at every single stand that appears in Part 3, along with a brief description of what the stand does, as well as who the stand user is. This list will be in order of appearance, so we'll start with the first stand that is ever revealed in JoJo, and end with the last stand that is revealed in Part 3. So to start this video off, the first stand to ever appear in JoJo's Bizarre Adventure, Star Platinum. Star Platinum, a very powerful and very versatile stand with only some of its abilities including its incredible strength, speed, and precision, and eventually will gain the ability to stop time. Star Platinum is a close range stand, so its range is only about 2 meters, and its user, of course, is Jotaro Kujo, the third main JoJo in the series. Magician's Red, an elemental type stand that has the ability to generate and manipulate fire. Some of this stand's most notable abilities are its Crossfire Hurricane, Red Bind, and its Life Detector. Magician's Red's user is of course Muhammad Avdol. Hermit Purple, a stand that provides its user telepathic abilities, enabling the user to sense locations or thoughts by projecting them into cameras or television screens. Hermit Purple also has other uses like means of transportation, or using it more of like a grappling hook because all the stand really is just vines. And the stand user, of course, is the legendary Joseph Joestar. Hierophant Green, a long-range stand that has a ton of different abilities that can either work for combat situations or more stealth or scouting situations. Hierophant Green's main abilities are its coiled body and Emerald Splash. Because of Hierophant Green's coiled body, it has the ability to unravel itself and manipulate its body and also go inside other people as a disguise. And the stand user is Noriaki Kakyoin. Tower of Gray, a stand that specializes in making its attacks look like accidents. Its most notable abilities being Tower Needle, which is just a long extended stinger that protrudes from its mouth and has the force to tear through flesh and rip things apart. And its other ability is its extremely high speed, being able to outmaneuver stands such as Star Platinum. Tower of Gray's user is Gray Fly. Silver Chariot, a stand that has a motherfucking sword. Silver Chariot is a badass stand that has its powers including its incredible speed, power, and precision. Silver Chariot is also equipped with armor and has the ability to remove the armor to increase his speed. And Silver Chariot's user is Jean-Pierre Polnareff. Dark Blue Moon, an aquatic type stand that is most effective in water. This stand is able to swim faster than any fish in the sea, and has different abilities like razor scales and barnacles. The barnacle abilities are just barnacles that the stand creates that attach to other stands or stand users. And once the barnacles are attached, they will drain the opponent of their strength. Dark Blue Moon's user was the imposter Captain Tennille. Strength, a stand that is capable of binding itself to inanimate objects to bring out their true potential. Whatever strength is bound to, it has the ability to completely manipulate whatever it is controlling. For example, Strength was controlling a yacht and was able to control all of the nuts and bolts and everything that made up that boat and able to attack its opponents. Very powerful stand if used effectively. This stand also grants its user the ability to travel through whatever it's controlling as if they were liquid. Strength's user is Forever, the first animal stand user that appears in the series. Ebony Devil, a stand that's power activates once its user is hit by an opponent. Then it grows more powerful depending on how much hatred the user feels towards the opponent. Then the stand can be bound to an inanimate object that attacks on its own. This ability is called Hatred Amplification, and the stand user is Devo the Cursed. Yellow Temperance, a stand with many different abilities, including its appearance replication that gives its user the ability to physically manipulate anything it sees, no matter what it is, almost instantaneously. Yellow Temperance is also extremely durable and is able to just nullify any physical damage it takes. It can resist large impacts, burning, and freezing. Yellow Temperance also has Assimilation. This ability allows Yellow Temperance to assimilate other flesh, using an opponent or just a random person's flesh to grow stronger and larger. It starts small, like on a pinky, like when we saw with Jotaro, but eventually has the ability to cover the entire body. Yellow Temperance stand user is Rubber Soul. Hanged Man, a stand that has the ability to attack through reflections. Rather than attacking the opponent directly, this stand has the ability to attack through anything that is reflective, such as a mirror, a reflection on, say, a car hood, or even human eyeballs. And this stand can move through these reflections at the speed of light. And that is its only weakness, that it actually has to physically move through the reflections. Hainman can produce knives from its wrist in order to attack the enemy for more destructive power. Hainman's stand user is J. Guile. Emperor, a stand that manifests as a gun and has the ability to appear and disappear in the user's hand. This stand is very powerful, but also very simple. Its main abilities are its homing bullets, its lack of recoil, increased reaction time, and its stealth capabilities. Emperor also has infinite bullets to shoot, because the bullets are an actual part of the stand. And Emperor's user is Whole Horse. Wheel of Fortune is a stand that is bound to a car. It has the ability of transformation, where it can change from a regular car into more of a combat-looking car with spikes all over it. And if it's damaged, it also has the ability to just completely repair itself and also improve its parts. Although Wheel of Fortune is a car, it does not have the same limitations as a car has, considering it can drive up 90 degree angles effortlessly. Its other abilities include its gasoline bullets, and also the ability to start electrical fires in order to light the gasoline that it shoots at its opponents, and also has the ability to communicate through other car radios. Wheel of Fortune's user is ZZ. Justice, a stand that is made up completely of fog and also has some pretty damn OP abilities, including its fog stream poetry, which allows the fog from the stand to enter an opponent's body if they have a wound on them anywhere on their body, and then gives Justice complete control over the living person. It also has corpse puppetry, which can completely summon the dead, sort of in a reanimation way, and just have an army of zombies that are completely under Justice's control. Justice also has the ability to create illusions. The stand created an illusion that projected an entire city over a graveyard. And also, this stand is extremely durable because it cannot be physically damaged because it is made of fog. Justice's user is Enya the Hag. The next stand we have is Lovers, and this stand's user took such a beating from Star Platinum. Let's see if we can finish this stand before Star Platinum finishes its beatdown. Okay, the Lover's primary ability is to enter the brain through the victim's ear and has the ability to increase pain receptors to make the opponent feel more pain. Lovers can also create clones through dead cells that have the exact same appearance as him and can create up to as many as 20 drones. Lovers can also use cells within the victim's brain to create a deadly spore that will eventually kill the person that they are attacking. The Lover's stand user is Steely Dan. The Sun, the stand that has the ability to replicate the sun. This stand's appearance is literally a sun, and it has the ability to increase heat to 176 degrees Fahrenheit. And also, it's able to attack vulnerable opponents with lasers that are pretty precise. The user actually has to be relatively close to the opponents that he's trying to affect because his stand is so powerful, and he is actually affected by his stand as well. The Sun's user is Arabia Fats. Death 13, a stand that attacks people in their dreams. Anytime anyone falls asleep around the user, it will bring them into the dream world where Death 13 and the user have absolute full control over. And if you fall asleep without your stand activated, your stand does not come into the world with you and you cannot use your stand. But if you do become unconscious with your stand out, you can bring your stand into the dream world. Any injuries you receive in the dream world will be transferred to the real world. And also, any injuries taken in the dream world are transferred into the real world. Death 13's user is actually a baby, Manish Boy. Judgment, a stand that has the ability to grant wishes in a sense that it will use its power to take a person's deepest emotions and turn that into an energy that can be used to form things from the dirt. For an example, he can trick people into wishing others back to life, which he can manipulate the dirt into turning them into those people. This stand also has exceptional strength and speed, and is also not connected to the user, in a sense that whatever damage the stand takes, the user does not take. Judgment's user is Cameo. High Priestess, a stand that has the ability to possess mineral substances and reform into any organic object. This ability works in a small scale and also a large scale environment, considering it originally just used itself to disguise as a mug, but eventually it took up a portion of the ocean floor that was large enough to imprison the Stardust Crusaders. It also has extremely hardened teeth when it was in the form that was on the ocean floor. The teeth were harder than diamonds, making it almost unbreakable. And the stand planned on using these teeth to crush its opponents by chewing them. And High Priestess's stand user was Midler. The Fool is a stand that is entirely made up of sand, and because it's made out of sand, it has the ability to shapeshift. The Fool can take the shape of anything it wants, from living people to just objects. But although this stand is made up of sand, it also has incredible strength and incredible speed. It also has very good durability as well, because attacking it would just mean you're just punching a pile of sand. And also the user is not harmed when the stand is attacked. The Fool's stand user is, of course, Iggy. Gab, a stand that is remotely controlled by its user who can control it precisely from miles away just by the sound that people make by touching the ground. This stand is also made entirely of water. And because this stand is made of water, like Iggy's stand, the Fool, it does not transmit damage to the user. The only way this stand does take damage, though, is by the water evaporating or burning the user. Geb's main offensive ability is its claw, strong enough to cut flesh and even rip off a human's head. The stand user is Indul. Kinnam, a stand that has the ability of transformation and allows its user to alter his appearance, height, weight, and scent. This stand is most often used to take the appearance of his enemies to sabotage them. The stand user is Oingo. Toth, a stand that has the ability to read the future. This stand manifests as a manga book that is mostly filled with blank pages, but as events happen, more pages will fill up, predicting coming events. It is true that the future events that appear in this book cannot be avoided in real life, but it's almost always the case that the predictions in the book are misinterpreted, or the prediction is always taken out of context. Toth's stand user is Boingo, and together they make Oingo and Boingo who always use their stands together. Except for, you know, when one of them dies. Anubis, a stand without a user that can control the body of whoever picks him up, the stand manifests as a sword. Its abilities include mind control, dimensional bypass, intelligent development, strength and speed development, and also selective drawing. With its mind control, it can control anyone, even a stand user. And also it can cut things without having to damage them. For example, it can cut someone's internal organs without having to damage their skin, if that makes sense. And of course, Anubis does not have a stand user, but was possessed by many characters throughout the series. Bastet, a stand that manifests as a regular American outlet, but when someone touches it, their bodies become strong magnetic forces. And the magnetic force that is put onto a person attracts anything metal nearby, eventually getting stronger and stronger, being able to attract entire vehicles to the target. But the further away the user gets from the affected target, the weaker the magnetic force will become, and if the user goes far enough away, the magnetic force will disappear. Bastet's stand user is Mariah. Sethan, a stand with the ability of age reversal. Anyone who stands in the shadow of the user will rapidly begin to age backwards. For example, Polnareff was in the shadow for a split second, approximately aged to 7 or 8 years old. So if you were standing in the shadow for more than a couple seconds, you would just die because you would be reversed all the way back to a fetus and eventually just to a sperm cell. This stand also has the ability of shadow reflection. Anything the user does, the stand will reflect as well because the stand does manifest as the user's shadow. Sethan's stand user is Alessi. Osiris, an automated stand that has the ability to take the soul of anyone who loses a bet against the user. The souls are then compressed into poker chips, which is the game that the user prefers to play, and it is then referred to as a soul poker chip. The stand user is Daniel J. Darby. Horus, a pretty simple elemental type stand that has the ability to control ice. Horus attacks by creating ice that can be thrown at the enemies. The ice is usually in the form of pointy shards and is flung with incredible speed and force. The user is also able to create ice inside their beak as a last attack or creating huge blocks of ice. Horus's user is another animal stand user, Pet Shop. Tenor's Sax, a stand that has the ability of illusions. This stand was only briefly shown in the series because the user was almost killed immediately, but his stand had the ability to create illusions in order to mask the interior of buildings. However, this stand was only able to mask appearance and not scent. The stand user was Kenny G. Atum, a stand that is very similar to Darby's Osiris considering it has the same ability of soul removal, but it is a little bit different. Atum has the ability to remove people's souls and place them in a doll, but before the soul is completely removed, Atum's opponent has to play the user in a video game of some sort, and if the opponent loses, then the soul is fully removed. Atum also has a binary lie detection ability where he can sense either yes or no coming from his opponent. The user is Daniel's younger brother, Telence D. Darby. Cream, a very powerful stand that has the ability of void and interdimensional access. Void allows Cream to devour itself, the stand, and the user in order to just turn itself into a ball of literal nothingness that destroys anything it touches. And its interdimensional access ability allows it to swallow its user in order for its user to access a different dimension that lies within the stand itself and is also able to bring things from the real world into that inner dimension. Cream's user is, of course, Vanilla Ice. And finally, the last stand to make its full appearance in JoJo's Bizarre Adventure Part 3, Stardust Crusaders, is Zawodo. The world has abilities very similar to JoJo's Star Platinum, considering they both have super strength, super speed, incredible precision, and super senses. But the world's most notable ability is its ability to stop time for a maximum of 11 seconds. And of course, the world's user is Dio Brando. Dio. There is actually two more stands in Stardust Crusaders that are unnamed, one of them being Holly's stand that we never saw a full version of and still to this day remains unnamed, and the other being Dio's version of Hermit Purple, which has some controversy of some people believing it's Jonathan's stand. But originally, Dio's stand the world was supposed to have every single stand combined into one, thus allowing him to use Hermit Purple, but that idea was scrapped near the end of Stardust Crusaders because that stand would have just been way too powerful. And that was every single stand that appeared in JoJo's Bizarre Adventure Part 3, Stardust Crusaders. Be sure to like this video if I occupied your boredom for a little bit, or if you just enjoyed. And also subscribe for more JoJo's Bizarre Adventure content. Thank you guys for watching the video, I hope you enjoyed.